Well, you know, you take defeat the way you take victory, you know, in stride. It's a part of the process. In victory, it's humility. In defeat, it's understanding.
How were you feeling going into tonight? Did you think you had had it on lock, or
no,
did you
no,
know it
no,
was a tough
race?
We
knew from the very beginning that we're bringing in only 40% of the population of the new ward, that it would be an uphill struggle. But the polls were very encouraging all throughout the campaign. The polls would have him ahead or me ahead. It would be going back and forth. So it truly was a fight, you know. He was throwing everything that he had into it, we were doing the same thing.
When you reflect back on all the years that you spent representing this area of Scarborough, what are some of your prouder moments?
Well, the transformation of an old hockey arena into the most modern, up-to-date recreational center in the city of Toronto, the renovation of the regional seniors center for the area, $1.5 million invested in Bridalwood and Agincourt libraries, mm-hmm. $5 million to upgrade children's playgrounds and the various parks and the communities I represent. A $6 million investment by the city into what is a work in progress, the first wellness center in the city of in the province
right.
of Ontario, involving the Scarborough General Hospital, United Way, and the Y. So there are lots of legacy issues here at City Hall. I think the two legacy issues would be Billy Bishop Airport.
Mm-hmm.
Myself and a few other guys decided to revive the Island Airport, and against a tremendous opposition mounted by the downtown councillors, we got it through council, and that airport today is contributing $2 billion a year to the downtown economy. And the second legacy issue in the city, of course, is my time as deputy mayor.